Hello friends, welcome to Conceptholic, the right place to get your concepts cleared. In this video, we will be learning about different IRC loadings for road bridges as per IRC 6/2016. This video forms the basis of bridge engineering and design and is very important from interviews and Viva's point of view. So watch this video till the end. Let us begin with the lecture. As per IRC 6/2016, there are four types of loadings. The first one is IRC class AA loading, the second one is IRC class 70R loading, the third one is IRC class A loading, and last but not the least is the IRC class B loading. We will be discussing each of them in detail. Before we discuss the loading standards, let us first understand about the wheeled vehicles and the tracked vehicles. As we can see here, the wheeled vehicles are the vehicles which move on wheels and we are very much familiar with them. On the other hand, the tracked vehicles are the vehicles which have metal belts. These are the metal belts, and these metal belts are driven by the wheels. These are the wheels. Now, a question arises: what was the need to introduce tracked vehicles? The simple answer is that due to a large contact area, as shown, the pressure generated is less because pressure is equal to force upon area. If area is more, pressure will be less, and hence the vehicle has very less chance of sinking in snow or in mud. This property of tracked vehicle is very useful for army tanks. Hope the type of vehicles are cleared. Now, let us understand in detail about the IRC class AA loading. As we can see here, a vehicle is said to be of IRC class AA loading if it is a tracked vehicle of total load 700 kN or 70 ton, or it is a wheeled vehicle of total load 400 kN or 40 ton. Now, let us understand in detail about the IRC class AA tracked vehicle. This is the typical side view and top view of IRC class AA tracked vehicle. There are certain IRC guidelines which we have to remember. The first one is that as per IRC, the entire 70 ton load is assumed to be distributed as 35 ton load on each of the two tracks as shown. IRC says that the ground contact length of IRC class AA tracked vehicle is 3.6 meter. Ground contact length is the actual length of the vehicle which touches the ground. This dimension is 0.850 meter, and hence we can say that the class AA tracked vehicle generates a ground print of 3.6 meter cross 0.85 meter. This is called as the nose of the vehicle, and this is the tail of the vehicle. As per IRC, the distance between the nose and tail of the vehicle should be 7.2 meter. IRC has also given some recommendations regarding the distance between two successive vehicles. And as per IRC, the distance between two successive vehicles should be minimum 90 meter to avoid congestion. IRC has also given some recommendations regarding the distance between the outermost face of the curb and the outermost part of the track. This distance is denoted by the letter C, as we can see here. As per IRC, the value of C should be minimum 1.2 meter. We have to picturize the entire IRC class AA tracked vehicle and remember this image so that we can use these distances as and when required in our problems. I hope this is clear. Now, moving on to IRC class AA wheeled vehicle. This is the typical front view and top view of IRC class AA wheeled vehicle. The loads 3.75 ton, 6.25 ton, 6.25 ton, and 3.75 ton, if we add them together and multiply it by 2, we will be getting a total load of 40 ton. In this case also, IRC has given some guidelines which we have to remember. The first one is that the center to center distance between the axles should be 1.2 meter maximum. This is the first axle and this is the second axle, and the center to center distance between them is this distance, and it should be 1.2 meter maximum. As we can see here, this is the direction of motion of the vehicle. In this case also, the nose to tail spacing between the successive vehicles should be minimum 90 meter, and here also the value of C should be minimum 1.2 meter. I hope this is cleared. Now let us move on to IRC class 70R loading. As we can see here, a vehicle is said to be of IRC class 70R loading if it is a tracked vehicle of total load 700 kN or 70 ton, or it is a bogie vehicle of total load 400 kN or 40 ton, or it is a wheeled vehicle of total load 1000 kN or 100 ton. Let us see about them in detail. Now, let us understand in detail about the IRC class 70R tracked vehicle. As we can see here, this is the typical sketch of IRC class 70R tracked vehicle. Here also, there are certain IRC guidelines which we have to remember. The first one is that in this case also, the entire 70 ton load is assumed to be distributed as 35 ton load on each of the two tracks as shown. In this case, the ground contact length is 4.570 meter and this dimension over here is 0.84 meter. Hence, we can say that the IRC class 70R tracked vehicle generates a ground print of 4.570 meter cross 0.84 meter. In this case also, as per IRC, the nose to tail spacing between the two successive vehicles should be 90 meter minimum. This recommendation is given to avoid the congestion on the road bridges. Here also, the minimum distance between the outer face of the curb, this is the outer face of the curb, and the outer part of the track is specified as per IRC, and it is denoted by the alphabet C. As per IRC, the minimum value of C should be 1.2 meter. I hope this is cleared. Now, let us understand IRC class 70R wheeled vehicles. As discussed earlier, a bogie vehicle of total load 40 ton also forms a class 70R vehicle. Also, a wheeled vehicle of total load 100 tons, which we get on adding all these wheel loads, this is 100 ton, forms a IRC class 70R vehicle. Now the important part is, from this view, it seems that the entire 17 ton load is concentrated on this single wheel only, but this is not the case. The tires in this case are arranged in patterns. They may be of L type, M type or N type depending upon the requirement. Let us understand it by taking an example. This is a typical IRC class 70R wheeled vehicle having M type arrangement. As we can see here, there are 4 tires in each row and the distance between those tires is 2.790 meter. We can see it from here also. This is the front view of the M type tires and this distance is 2.790 meter. This distance is also 2.790 meter. As there are 4 tires in each row, there are a total of 4 into 7 is equal to 28 tires overall in this case. Similarly, if it would have been N type tire, there would have been 8 tires in each line and a total of 56 tires overall. I hope this concept is cleared. Now, let us understand IRC class A loading. As we can see here, the IRC class A loading consists of a wheel load train composed of a driving vehicle. This is the driving vehicle. And this driving vehicle is used to pull these trailers. These are the trailers. We have to remember these load values. This is the typical top view of this driving vehicle. Here also IRC has given some guidelines which we have to remember. The first guideline as per IRC is the distance between the two successive vehicles should be 18.5 meter. They are talking about this distance. It should be minimum 18.5 meter. Also, IRC has given some guidelines regarding the ground contact area. They have defined two dimensions, B and W. As we can see here, this dimension is B and this one is W. They have given the values of B and W for different axle loads. For example, if the axle load is 11.4 ton, the value of B is 250 mm and the value of W is 500 mm. So here we can see that for axle load 11.4 ton means for this wheel, the value of B is 250 mm and the value of W is 500 mm. I hope this is cleared. Now, consider a case in which there is a road bridge and there are two lanes. On both the lanes, there are IRC class A loading vehicles. Now, we have to define these terms F and G. First of all, G is the distance between the outermost part of both the vehicles, as we can see here. F is the distance between the outermost face of the curb and the outermost part of the wheel. This is the distance F. IRC has given some guidelines regarding the values of F and G. As per IRC, the value of F is 150 mm for all the cases, whereas the value of G varies between 0.4 meter and 1.2 meter. If the value of G is 0.4 meter, the clear carriageway width comes out to be 5.3 meter, and if the value of G is 1.2 meter, the clear carriageway width comes out to be 6.1 meter. Now let us understand how this 5.3 value comes. So this is 5.3 is equal to F. F is 150 mm, so 0.150 plus this distance. As we can see here, this distance is W by 2. So we have taken this highest value W, 500 mm, so 0.5 by 2 plus this distance, which is the center to center distance between the tires, and this distance as given here is 1.8 meter. So this 1.8 meter is justified, plus again W by 2, which is 0.5 by 2, then G, which is 0.4, plus again W by 2, which is 0.5 by 2, plus again the center to center distance, which is 1.8, then again we are here, so 0.5 by 2 and then again 0.150. If we change the value of G from 0.4 to 1.2 here, we will get the clear carriageway width is as 6.1 meter. I hope this concept is clear. Now let us move on to IRC class B loading. IRC class B loading is also similar to IRC class A loading. In this case, also there are the two trailers which are driven by a driving vehicle. This is the driving vehicle. The only difference is that the loads differ in this case, and we have to remember the loads. Here are also some IRC recommendations. In this case also, the nose to tail spacing between the successive vehicles should be 18.5 meters. They are talking about this distance, 18.5 meters. Here also IRC has given some recommendations regarding the ground contact area depending upon the axle loads. It is similar to IRC class A loading, the values of B and W as per the axle loads. Now here also we have already defined the meaning of G and F. In this case also, the value of F is 150 mm for all carriageway widths, and G varies between 0.4 meter to 1.2 meter. If we take the value of G as 0.4 meter, we will get clear carriageway width as 5.06 meter, and 1.2 meter, then we will get clear carriageway width of 5.86 meter. We have already discussed the logic behind this 5.06 meter. The logic remains the same in this case also. I hope all the IRC loadings are cleared and you are thorough with the concepts. If you like the lecture, do like this video and share it as much as possible, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such videos on bridge engineering and civil engineering. Stay tuned and happy learning.